Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's the greatest pleasure to welcome you all to this high-level meeting in the context of the COVID-19 pandemic that has affected many countries around the world. The aim of this meeting is to secure commitments at the higher level with a view to protecting and promoting education as a pillar for resilient and sustainable recovery and reigniting the progress across the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. Let me say from the outset that my colleague and co-chair of the SDG Advocacy Group, Her Excellency Prime Minister Solberg, and I are delighted by the assurance that countries are committed to the attainment of the SDGs, especially in the education sector, in spite of the pandemic. Excellencies, distinguished ladies, the COVID-19 pandemic has exposed considerable challenges within the education sectors of many countries around the world. And the importance of teachers are better recognized by all now. In many developing countries, the digital divide has meant that many children from deprived and rural backgrounds have not been able to take advantage of the online platforms that have been made available to facilitate teaching and learning during these challenging times. We in Ghana have introduced a phased reopening of schools and blended learning to ensure that academic activities are ongoing. We have also started the Ghana Learning TV and the Ghana Learning Radio with supplementary home readers to enable parents and teachers to support home learning, and also created a cloud-based knowledge and skills bank to enable remote learning. Even so, there are still challenges of access for many children. It is therefore imperative that we all avert our minds to the importance of building resilient educational systems that would be able to endure and be available to all children and learners. We must step up our efforts at engaging innovative financing models to ensure that education is not negatively affected. This is particularly urgent because education is at considerable risk of being overshadowed in terms of financing sources, despite its important role as a driver of economic recovery in the short term and sustainable development in the long term. Excellencies, these setbacks risk compromising and even reversing the gains that have been made towards the attainment of SDG 4. Pushing millions out of education systems and lowering their chances of future employability and decent livelihoods. This meeting is particularly important in ensuring a joined up effort to recentering education and ensuring that indeed no child is left behind as we strive to protect our gains and meet our SDG targets by 2030. Finally, I wish to pledge the support of the government and the people of Ghana to this important global cause and to UNESCO's coordinating role of SDG 4. I wish you all a very successful meeting. Thank you.